Now, John Sossel, who is now a member of the Fox family. I love that, the Fox family. He wants to legalize pot, and I debated him on Tuesday. Roll the tape. 75% of all the child neglect and abuse in America is caused by drug-involved adults, and I think that includes alcohol as well. Okay.
Yes. Yeah,
okay.
Probably 90%
of it. You, John Stossel, want to legalize, want to make it easier for adults to get whacked out on all substance when 75% of all the abuse is caused by that.
But you're suggesting that if it's legal, then many more people would get whacked out. They're getting whacked out now.
I'm suggesting that if you make it legal,
as Portugal
has, more people
and fewer people are using it.
All right. So, I mean, I am suggesting that if pot and all drugs, as Sasa wants to legalize all drugs, are legal, Carlson, it is much easier to get intoxicated. And the signal is there's nothing wrong with it. What say you?
Yeah, I think we don't know what the ramifications would be in the United States of America if suddenly we legalize all drugs.
Well, we know because some England tried it, Switzerland tried it, and they revoked it because it led to so many problems that the societies that have legalized narcotics, most of them have revoked the legalization because of all the unintended consequences.
I do want to say this, that I think it's one thing to have a free spirit attitude, but it's a whole other thing to have a denigration of the rules and regulations in society, and that would be my concern about what would happen here.
Yeah, but if the rules are outdated, outmoded, not, too intrusive, Hoover, then maybe they need to be reexamined. But there is no doubt that child abuse and neglect is caused by intoxication. And it is. And how you can say that if you can go down to 7-Eleven and buy crack or meth, you're not going to have more use of it is impossible for me to fathom. Of course you'll have more use of it.
One thing, you and Stossel started to get into a tit-for-tat, which is worse, alcohol versus pot. You know, it's likely that the parents who are hitting their kids are the ones who are drunk, not the ones who are smoking too much pot.
Well wait a minute. How do you know that?
Well, actually,
if your thinking process is skewed by a substance, you know, you don't know that.
I think most of the evidence suggests that people who are high on pot tend to be more sedated rather than
what about
riled
crack?
Up.
What about meth?
Look,
what about
if you're on crack and meth, you're doing all sorts of other stuff. Look, I agree with you. I'm glad that you're protecting the kids and you're looking out for the kids. The other problem, too, with legalizing drugs, though, as we've seen in Amsterdam, as we've seen in the Netherlands, as we've seen in Rotterdam and other societies, is major crime problems move in. As your words, not mine, organized crime controls vice the world over.
Sure.
And as soon as you legalize drugs, crime moves in. That's what I'd be very curious to hear Mr. Stossel's answer
to. And I'm concerned, Bill, about, as a parent, how the heck do you parent this? Because your message right now to your kids is don't do drugs, and one of the biggest things that you can hang your hat on is because it's illegal. And
right.
Suddenly when it's legal, what in the heck do parents
tell
their kids?
See, I think it's a surrender. The country basically says, look, it's not worth it. I would decriminalize marijuana in a sense that I wouldn't hunt it down, but I'd still prosecute dealers, and if anybody was in a car under the influence, they'd get book thrown at them. But I do think it's a surrender. The culture warriors, everybody.